فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على من أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، وإلى كتاب الورقات للإمام أبي معالي الجوين رحمه الله إمام الحرمين. We have previously taken dividing كلام باعتبار ما يتركب منه, dividing speech into its component بما يتركب منه, which we took was اسم, فعل, and حرف. Good. We also took وأقل ما يتألف منه, the minimum a speech can be. So that was the تركيب, the compound of the word. We're going to divide speech, inshallah ta'ala, كلام into what? باعتبار مدلوله. We're going to divide it from the angle of what? From the angle of what it indicates. And the كلام باعتبار مدلوله, dividing speech in what it indicates, is two types. Dividing speech into that which he indicates is either khabar or insha. Khabar or insha. The khabar is what? The definition of khabar is ma yahtamilu الصدق والكذبة في لذاته. Khabar is a news. It is anything which you can say when the person tells you you lied or you said the truth. But when I use the word لذاته for a reason, because when you can say that you're lying or you're telling the truth is based on who said it. If the person who said it doesn't lie, you can't say you said the truth or the lie, because now you're looking at it through the person who said it. When Allah says something, you don't say Allah lied, rather you say everything Allah said is true. So that's why the word لذاته has to be in there, because the speech in and within itself, like in يحتمل الكذب والصدق. Like when we say who said it, Allah لا يحتمل إلا الصدق. Good. It's important that you understand that point. The insha is the opposite to khabar. The insha is what? It's the opposite to khabar. It is anything which you can't say. ما لا يحتمل الصدق والكذب. It is anything which you can't say you're right, you told the truth, or you lied. You can't say it. Insha, that's what it means. It is anything which you can't say to a person, you've lied or you've told the truth. Such as if a person says to you, uktub, write. Can you say, oh, you lied? Can you say you said the truth? No. If a person prevents you from something, he says to you, for instance, he says to you, la taktub, don't write. Can you say you said the truth? Can you say both of the ones I just told you was the amr and the nahi? Uktub was what? Amr. Which was uktub, right? It's an amr. La taktub, don't write, is what? It's a?
Prohibition.
It's a prohibition which is called a nahi. A nahi. What does it fall under? Can I say to a person who told me don't write, can I say you're lying? You said the truth? So what does that fall under?
Insha.
Insha. Good. Also, what about istikhbar? A person asks me something. He says to me, هل فهمت الدرس? Did you understand the lesson? Can I say you lied? Can I say you said the truth? He asks me a question. I can't. It falls under insha. Good. Somebody comes up to you and says to you, أَحَذَرَ خَالِدٌ Did Khalid become present at the class today? You can't say you lied or you said the truth. That's istikhbar or it's called istifham. Also, تَبَنِّن A person wishes for something. He wishes for something. He says, for example, the word تَمَنِّن is what? تَمَنِّن means wishful thinking. تَمَنِّن means when you wish for something that won't happen. It won't happen. It's like a person who says, لَيْتَ الشَّبَابُ يَعُودُ يَوْمًا فَأُقْبِلُهُ بِمَا يَفْعَلُهُ الْمَشِيبُ If only I regained being a shab. I got the opportunity to become a what? A person who reaches being a youth. Would that be possible, a person who's very old, to hope to become a youth again? Nah, this is tamanni. It's called tamanni. So you say to a person, you lied or you said the truth? La, you can't. Good. Wa'ardin. And ardin means what? Remember? The word ardin. Bisukun ra. So you say ardin. You put sukun on it. What is it? It is a person who asks something in a very tender and a soft way. Which is, it's like he presents the idea to you, but he doesn't. It's like he's asking you in a very soft way. Ala tanzil indana? Example, what a person says to you, why don't you stay with us? He never said to you, stay with us. That would be all order or akbar. But he didn't say to you also, are you going to stay with us? But he says, why don't you stay with us? This is called ard. He's presented the thought to you. The last one is called qasam. Qasam means what? Remember, bifatḥ al-qafi was seen. Qasam. What does that mean? It is an oath. Hal hilf. If a person says, wallahi la af'alanna al-khayr. Wallahi, I'm going to do good. You can't say you're lying. You can't say you're saying the truth. All of those fall under what? Insha. All of them fall under? And the two most important ones, the usuliyun, they focused highly on, that is the biggest points and the biggest chapter, is the amr and the nahi. The order and the prohibitions are the biggest of this. So let's read, inshallah ta'ala, the speech of Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni. And also let's read the sharah and explanation of Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan, and matters will become much more clear to us, inshallah. والكلام speech ينقسم it is divided into إلى أمر is divided into an order ونهي prohibition وخبر news واستخبار questioning وينقسم أيضا is also divided into إلى تمن it is also divided into a wishful thinking or wishful hoping وعرض and presentation or asking in a kind way وَقَاسَمٍ and an oath. So let's take the sharah, inshaAllah ta'ala. He said, Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan said, لَمَّا فَرَغَ الْمُصَنِّفُ He said, when the author had spoken about أَقْسَامُ الْكَلَامُ when he spoke about the types of speech بِاعْتِبَارِ مَا يَتَرَكَّبُ مِنْهُ when he finished speaking about the speech, how it's divided as a compound, when he spoke about that, shara'a, he went into looking at it. Fi dhikri aqsam bi'tibari madlulihi, he went to speak about, or he embarked on speaking about, or mentioning the types from the perspective of what it indicates. So once he spoke about that which it's compound, he went into what? He went into that which it indicates. قوله, now he's explaining it, Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan, he said, the speech of Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni, where he says, وَالْكَلَامُ يَنْقَسِمُ إِلَىٰ أَمْرٍ He said, the speech of Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni, when he said, وَالْكَلَامُ speech, يَنْقَسِمُ is divided into, إِلَىٰ أَمْرٍ order, وَهُوَ that pronoun goes back to what? It goes back to Amr. He's trying to say, وَهُوَ أَيْ the order is, what's the order? What's the amr? He's explaining this to you. Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan is saying this. It is, مَا يَدُلُّ that which indicates, عَلَى طَلَبِ الْفِعْلِ An order is, when you are requested to do an action, نَحْوَ like, أَطِعْ وَالِدَيْكَ Obey your parents. That's the amr. وَقَوْلُهُ And the speech of the author, where he said, وَنَهْيِمْ When the author, Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni said, وَنَهْيِمْ prohibition. Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan said, وَهُوَ The nahyi, the prohibition. What does it mean? It is مَا يَدُلُّ that which indicates عَلَى طَلَبِ التَّرْكِ It is what indicates the request of leaving something. It is a request to leave something. Such as what? نَحُو لَا تَكْذِبْ It is like saying, such as saying, don't lie. في حديثك, don't lie in your speech. وقوله, and also in the speech of the author Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni, where he said, وَخَبَرٍ, خَبَر, news, he said, وَهُوَ, Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzani is explaining what khabar means. It is مَا يَحْتَمِلُ, that which it shows or can carry الصدق, it can carry it being truth, والكذب, or it being a lie, such as what? سَافَرَ خَالِدٌ, خَالِد traveled. You can say كَذَبْت, you lied, or you can also say you told the truth, صدقت. وَقَوْلُهُ, at the speech of the author when he said وَالْإِسْتِخْبَار, when Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni used the word istikhbar, it means al-istifham. The word istikhbar means what? Istifham, to question. And to question means طَلَبُ الْعِلْم, it is to request the knowledge of a matter, بِشَيْءٍ لَمْ يَكُنْ مَعْلُومًا, that was not known to you مِنْ قَبْلُ, before. نَحْوَ, such as مَا فَهِمْتُ الْمَسْأَلَةِ, sorry, هَلْ فَهِمْتَ الْمَسْأَلَةِ, have you understood the matter? وَيَنْقَسِمُ, it is divided into أيضًا, also إِلَى تَمَنِّن. تَمَنِّن means what? Wishful thinking. I'm a wishful hope. The person is wishing for something that won't take place. وَهُوَ, Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni said, وَيَنْقَسِمُ أَيْضًا, it is also divided into إِلَى تَمَنِّن, into تَمَنِّن. What does it mean? Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan said, وَهُوَ تَمَنِّ, means طَلَب, to request a shay'a, to request a matter, al-mahbub, that is loved to you, الَّذِي لَا يُرْجَى, but it's not hoped, حُصُولُهُ, that it will happen. تَمَنِّ means you are looking and asking for a matter which is loved to you, but it's not hoped for it to take place. إِمَّا لِكَوْنِي, maybe it is مُسْتَحِيلَ, and it's impossible. Such as if the person says, لَيْتَ الشَّبَابُ يَعُودُ يَوْمًا, only if being a youngster could come back again. لِذَلِكَ, they say that there was an old man who used to be very strong. He used to go to the well by himself, and he would throw the bucket into the well, and the water, when it fills it up, if the bucket is very big and water fills in it, it's very hard for a person to bring it up by himself. This man used to do it alone, and so he would do it. But when he grew a bit old, he felt like his body was heavy and he couldn't do it, and he felt pain. And so he made a couple of lines of poetry where he said, مَالِي إِذَا جَذَبْتُهَا سَعِيتُ. He said, why is it when I throw the bucket into the well and the water is in it, and then I try to bring it up, I feel like I have to work more. أَكِبَرٌ, is it because I've reached an old age? عَلَنًا أَمْ بَيْتٌ, or is it because a house has been placed on top of me? The reason why he means a house is placed upon me is that I got married. And the man, when he is not married, he's stronger than when he gets married. Marriage weakens the person. Later, if only. And then he said, later, if only, وَهَلْ يَنْفَعُ شَيْءَ لَيْتُ, and then he said, later. He said, would later benefit me anything? لَيْتَ شَبَابًا بُوعَ فَاشْتَرَيْتُ, if only being a youngster was something that could be bought, and I would go and buy it for myself. If only it was something sold, I would buy it for myself. Meaning, the word later, even he realized that the usage of the word later and hoping is not going to happen. So he said, later, وَهَلْ يَنْفَعُ شَيْءًا, would later benefit me anything? The answer is no. It won't benefit you. You won't go back to the age of being young again in your life. Naam. Or it can also sometimes occur from a person who the thing which they are hoping, they've really given up from it. It's called مُنْقَطْعُ الرَّجَاء. The person's really given up. And they say, لَيْتَلِي, if only I was to have مَال and wealth, فَأَحُجَّ بِهِ, which I could do hajj. But he's really given up. He's poor excessively. This is not impossible, but it's called مُنْقَطْعُ الرَّجَاء. The hope for him to do hajj is not really close right now, because he's in a very tricky situation. You see? Good. Then Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni said, وَعَرْضٍ بِسُكُونِ الرَّاء. That ra has to have a sukun on it. What is it? هُوَ الطَّلَبُ, بالرفق. It is when you ask something in a very soft and tender way. Such as if you to say to somebody, ألا تنزل عندنا? Why don't you descend on us? I mean, why don't you stay with us? It's asking in a very soft way. Also, وقاسام. قسم means an oath. بفتح القاف والسين. قاسام. That's how you say it. وهو. The قسم means الحلف. It means to make an oath. Such as if a person says, Wallahi by Allah, لا أفعلن الخير. I'm going to do good. Now there's an important point that needs to be pointed out that Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan is going to point out. He said, وَإِنَّمَا قَالَ الْمُصَنِّفُ. He said, the author said, وَيَنْقَسِمُ أَيْضًا. If you go back to the method, you will see that the author, Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayli said, it is also divided into. After he mentioned the Amr, the Nahi, the Khabar, the Istikhbar, then he says it's also divided into. Once you've mentioned at the beginning that something is divided in this way, and halfway through the speech, if you say it's also divided into, the person would think that this is another type of dividing, correct? The case is not like that. Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan points that out. Because all of that which he mentioned, all of them fall under insha. All of them fall under insha. And there is not two types of division. All of them are one type. But why did he do that? The reason why he did it is because a lot of the scholars of Usuliyun, what they do is when they talk about Insha, they only mention Amr, Nahi, Khabar, and Istifham. Only those four. And they leave out what? Tamannin, and Arda, and Qasam. So he also said, he mentioned that and emphasized on it. And Shaykh Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan will explain that. He said, Isharatan. The reason he did that is because he wanted to point out إِلَىٰ أَنَّ مِنَ الْأُصُولِيِّينَ. Because from the أُصُولِيِّين are those مَنْ اِقْتَصَرَ, those who have shortened عَلَى التَّقْسِيمِ الْأَوَّلِ, who have chosen the first type, which is الْأَمْرُ وَالنَّهِ وَالْخَبَرُ وَالْإِسْتِخْبَارُ, which is the istifham. وَأَنَّهُ يَرُدُّ عَلَى التَّقْسِيمِ الثَّانِي, which reject the second type. وَأَنَّ الْجَمِيعَ تَقْسِيمُ الْوَاحِدُ, and that all of these are one type. وهناك تقسيم أخسر من هذا. Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan says, this type that Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni came with, which is how many times did he mention? Amrun, one. وَنَهْيٌ وَخَبَرٌ وَاسْتِخْبَارٌ وَتَمَنٍ وَعَرْضٍ وَقَسَمٌ. Seven, right? Student of knowledge might get confused, and it's not good for him. So Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan said, وهناك تقسيم أخسر من هذا. There is a more abridged categorization. كما عند البلاغيين, as is according to the علماء بلاغة. وهو أن الكلام قسمان, that the speech is two types. خبر وإنشاء. Which we just took. Instead of saying all these seven, the student has to be confused. The student is told there is خبر and there's إنشاء. The خبر is what we took before. ما يحتمل الصدق والكذب لذاتي. We took that. And inshallah, there's going to be a whole chapter which is called باب الأخبار. We're going to talk about it. The second one is called what? إنشاء. وهو ما لا يحتمل الصدق والكذب. إنشاء means what? It is anything which you can't say it's a lie or it's a truth. كقولك, like your speech. اكتب, right. لأن المدلول, because the indication, لا يحصل إلا بالتلفظ به. It cannot occur except by pronouncing it. فلا يقال, a person cannot say to you صدق أو كذب. He can't say he lied or he told the truth. ومن الإنشاء, from the إنشاء is all these seven. These seven are all إنشاء that we mentioned, which is الأمر والنهي والاستفهام والتمنين. ومنه, all of them is what? العرض. العرض. The scholars, they divide the إنشاء into two. The إنشاء is divided into two. And what is that? إنشاء طلبي and إنشاء غير طلبي. Amar, Nahi, Istifham, and Tamanni, and also Arb. The first, the first one is Amar, Nahi, Khabar, Istighbar, or Istifham, whichever you say, and Arb. Are you guys with me? And also Tamanni. All of those are what? All of those are Insha Talabi. Qasam, Qasam is what? It's an insha غير طلبي. What does that mean? Insha طلبي means insha, that's a request. All of these are طلب, right? Is the amr a talab? Is it a request? Is the prohibition a request? Yes, it's a request to leave something. Is a istifham? Is it a request? Good. It's tamanni a request. It's a request. What about ard? Is it a request? That's fine. Good. What about qasam? It's not. It's an oath. It's not a tamanni. It's not a request. So this is called insha' ghayra talabi. وَأَهَمُّ هَذِي الْأَنْوَعِ The most important from the seven of the insha', from the seven of the insha', the most important one is الأمر والنهي, the order and the prohibition. وَسَيَأْتِي And it will come. The speech regarding them too. Regarding who? Regarding order and prohibition. Inshallah, if Allah wills. وَأَمَّا بَقِيَّةُ الْأَنْوَعِ As for the other remaining five. As for the other remaining five. Which is what? خبر واستخبار وتمني وعرض وقسم. Those five. Yeah. فلا يترتب عليها. The other remaining five. There really doesn't result from it. For the أصوليون, a lot of benefits. They don't really get a lot of benefits from the other five. The other five, they don't get a lot of benefit from it. والله أعلم. And Allah knows best. وسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا الله استغفرك واتوب اليك